Greetings. Continuing our dissection and exposures of the lies and errors in Deedat's combat kit against God's people. Let's continue with 2b. B. The villages that Kedar doth inhabit. Isaiah 42:11. Kedar being Ishmael's offspring. Arabia and all the princes of Kedar. Ezekiel 27:21. The International Standard Bible Encyclopedia quotes the following from A.S. Fulton. Of the Ishmaelite tribes, Kedar must have been the most important, and thus in later times the name came to be applied to all the wild tribes of the desert. It is thought Kedar that Muslim genealogists trace the descent of Muhammad from Ishmael. This is an effort by Deedat to attempt to imply that mere mention of an Arabian town, Kedar, is somehow a prophetic reference to the man Muhammad. But if you think back to video 1 of this series, Isaiah spoke a curse against Kedar, a very harsh judgment. Here is a brief refresher of the context and prophecy against Kedar. For they fled from the swords, from the drawn sword, and from the bent bow, and from the grievousness of war. For thus hath the Lord said unto me, within a year, according to the years of an hireling, and all the glory of Kedar shall fail. And the residue of the number of archers, the mighty men of the children of Kedar, shall be diminished, for the Lord God of Israel hath spoken it. I said these were not happy words for Kedar. The point of Deedat highlighting the word Kedar is really typical for Deedat in Islam. There is literally no interest in reading and learning and understanding. The mention by A.S. Fulton is historical in nature, and it does mention that Islamic scholars attempt to trace Muhammad from Ishmael using Kedar. But I honestly do not know if they make that claim just to glom onto the word Kedar, as they do with every other word of convenience. Camel comes to mind. Prophet? Farthest. Farthest, you ask? Well, it provides interesting insight that Islam does not even respect its own book. They freely take the word farthest, as in farthest mosque, from the Quran, as a claim of the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem. But neither the word Jerusalem nor the name Al-Aqsa appear anywhere in the Quran. So truthfully, they have no more regard for their Quran in terms of accuracy or faithful reading. The villages that Kedar doth inhabit, Isaiah 42:11. And this is the extent of the mention in 2b. Deedat trying to claim mention of Kedar is a prophetic reference to Muhammad. And just as a refresher, Muhammad claimed in his Quran that he was mentioned in the Torah and Injil. Right, the Torah being the Pentateuch, the first five books of the Bible, and the Injil being the New Testament, or perhaps limited to the four Gospels. So even if we imagined Isaiah or Ezekiel were mentions of Muhammad, neither is in the Torah nor the Injil. Which begs the questions. Regardless of these two references, where are the mentions in the Torah and Injil? If these are mentions of Muhammad, why didn't Allah know where they were? Why didn't Allah say the prophet mentioned by prophets Isaiah and Ezekiel? If these are mentions of Muhammad, why is there no mention of a prophet of Kedar? If these are mentions of Muhammad, why does Muhammad not call himself the prophet of Kedar? You see, Jesus called himself the Son of Man that prophecies might be associated and fulfilled. And Jesus called himself the Son of God because that was who he was. But I can find no record of Muhammad calling himself the prophet of Kedar. Point C. He, Muhammad, peace be upon him, shineth forth from Mount Paran in Arabia, and he came with 10,000 saints, Deuteronomy 33:2, referring to the conquest of Mecca, or Mecca. Now for this claim, we need to strip out Deedat's inserted words. You know how Deedat likes to change and add to the Word of God. Then we are left with, he shined forth from Mount Paran, and he came with 10,000 saints, Deuteronomy 33:2. But let us be good Bereans and examine this text in context. Deuteronomy 33:1. And this is the blessing wherewith Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death. And he said, The Lord came from Sinai, and rose up from Seir unto them. He shined forth from Mount Paran, and he came with 10,000s of saints. From his right hand went a fiery law for them. O my God! Do you see what this slimy son of Satan has done? Who is this talking about? The Lord God. And he, Moses, said, The Lord came from Sinai and rose up from Seir unto them. See, it says the Lord right there. He shined forth from Mount Paran. He, the Lord God. Can you see it? This verse is talking about God. Do you see what this slimy son of Satan has done? Dear God, if you have any regard for the truth, you need to recognize just what a liar Deedat was. Deedat takes a verse from the Torah, rips it out of context, and claims Mohammed is the God it speaks of. I knew Deedat was a liar. I was not expecting this when I looked up this verse. Deedat takes a verse from Prophet Moses, where Moses speaks of God, and Deedat uses it to mean Mohammed. Wow. Sorry, but I just can't get over this. Not until you poor souls in Islam understand the depth of lies you are told. And he, Moses, said, The Lord came from Sinai and rose up from Seir unto them. He shineth forth from Mount Paran, and he came with 10,000s of saints. He, Moses, said, This is Moses, Prophet Moses. You know, Moses, peace be upon him, Moses. The Lord came. This is the Lord God of Abraham. The Hebrew here is Yahweh. You know, your Allah is our Allah? Yeah, that Yahweh. The Lord Yahweh came from Sinai. Or Allah came from Sinai, if you prefer. Deuteronomy 33:2. Yahweh, the Lord. Sinai came. He. He is a pronoun. It is a substitute. It replaces something called the antecedent. In this case, the Lord Yahweh. Remember? Allah? The Allah Islam claims sent Moses? This verse speaks of the Lord God coming with his saints. Do you understand what this means, O pagan Mohammedan? What? Don't like being called pagans? Then please tell me, what do you call it that Mohammed is taught as the God of Abraham? That Mohammed is taught filling Allah's place. And this begs some questions. In all the years that Deedat taught his combat kit, of all the thousands of Mohammedans who took the course, the millions who sat through the lectures, the millions who heard it repeated to this day, why have none of you cared enough about God to look this up? This is lesson 2C of the combat kit. It is one of the first things, and all I had to do was look up the verse and read it. And this begs some more questions. What do you do now with this information, O Mohammedan? How much do you love Deedat before you love God, above your Allah? How much do you love Deedat above your Allah? Do you love Deedat like you love Mohammed more than God? I challenge you, Mohammedan, to look this up yourself. But more than that, I challenge you to look up on every Islamic website you know and see if any one of them regards God enough to know this. Or do they publish this blasphemy called Deedats Combat Kit? Please help me understand, O Mohammedans. Do you agree when Moses talks of Allah, he means Muhammad? Why has not one Mohammedan on earth cared enough to read this verse? And what about you, O Mohammedan? Or should I say pagan Mohammedan, blaspheming Mohammedan? How can I call you anything other than pagan? You accept when Moses spoke of Allah, he was meaning Muhammad. You follow, honor, and revere a man who teaches Muhammad is God, spoken of by Moses. Maybe you do not care Deedat taught Muhammad is God. Please let me know if you worship Muhammad or if you honor God, my friend. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.